What is a hydrograph? You may have seen these graphs on the internet, whether on a National Weather Service webpage, Facebook post, or tweet, or you may have seen these on your local news station during times of flooding. A hydrograph is a plot of observed and forecast river height and flow with time. Each point on the graph represents two different variables, river height in units of feet, found on the left side, and river flow in units of CFS, which stands for cubic feet per second. It can also say KCFS, which stands for 1,000 cubic feet per second. On the left side of the image, the blue dots represent the observed river height and flow, while on the right side, the purple squares signify the forecast height and flow. The observed stage points are measured via a United States Geological Survey sensor located in the river. The forecast points come from the National Weather Service River Forecast Centers found across the country. Their hydrologists and meteorologists produce these sophisticated modeling tools that simulate soil, snow, and river conditions. The points are plotted with local time, which are shown on the x-axis on the bottom. There are different river stages that the National Weather Service uses to describe what the river is doing and what potential impacts the public may experience. Action stage is a stage at which you are getting close to the flood stage. Minor flooding means that there will be minimal or no property damage, but possibly some public threat. Moderate means that there will be some flooding of structures and roads near the river. Some evacuations of people and/or transfer of property to higher elevations is possible. A major flood stage means extensive flooding of structures and roads, significant evacuations of people and/or transfer of property to higher elevations. Record flooding, highest gauge and flow readings ever recorded for that period of record. So let us look at this Yaak River hydrograph. Here is a non-flooding example. At 3 p.m. April 4th, the observed river height was just near 6 feet, and the volume of water rushing past the sensor was measured at 2,490 cubic feet per second. Think of a cubic foot of water as that equal to fill a basketball, over 2,000 basketballs passing through in 1 second. The forecast shows that the height of the river will rise to 7 feet by Monday, April 11th. Here is a major flooding example. This point here, which is within the moderate flood stage, occurred between 10 p.m. and 4 a.m. on May 1st. What is happening in this graph? Well, this river has shown a dramatic rise in the river levels in a short amount of time. It rose from 5 feet at 10 p.m. to 15 feet at 4 a.m. the next morning. The flow increased from being 1,400 CFS to around 11,000 cubic feet per second within 24 hours. That is a very large amount of water flow. This is a major flooding scenario. You can see the observed river height protruded into the purple zone here. Still, this height was 6 feet from the record stage of 21 feet. In this scenario, over 6 inches of rain fell within 2 days, causing rivers to rise quickly. How do you find hydrographs? There are at least two ways of getting to the graphs. One is to go to the hydrology link on your local National Weather Service Forecast Office webpage, or you can go straight to the AHAPS page at water.weather.gov. AHAP stands for Advanced Hydrologic Prediction Service. The main AHAPS page displays all the available river gauges found across the United States. Each point is color-coded to match the particular river stage that it is currently experiencing. Left-click on the area that you want to look at, and it will zoom in. If you hover your mouse over a particular station, a hydrograph will pop up. If you left-click on a station, you will be able to get more information. If you hover your mouse cursor over a point, it will give you that specific information. Scroll down the page and you will see where the river gauge is located, what the flood categories are, and give you historic and recent river crests. These give you a picture of how high the river can flood in relation to history. Scroll down some more. In the flood impact section, you can get an understanding of what particular areas will flood based on what has flooded in the past along a section of the river that the gauge represents. For the National Weather Service, I'm Dave Noble.